There's a national discussion now evolving on assisted reproductive technologies, the causes of infertility, and the structural inequalities faced by those experiencing fertility challenges is the focus of next week's NOVA Science Series from Minneapolis producer Larkin McPhee.
My name is Larkin McPhee. I am a producer, writer, director of documentary films, and I'm currently been working with NOVA on a film about fertility, which will be airing this May on PBS. We actually went around the country to tell stories. We began in my backyard here in Minneapolis. It's a very experimental time right now.
Infertility just feels like a special little corner of hell.
I think there's an infertility pandemic, and I think it's getting worse.
Black women are struggling with infertility at almost two times the rate as our Caucasian brothers and sisters.
One thing that people would always say is that two men can't make a baby. And so I'm sort of like, watch us.
Fighting for fertility on NOVA.
The story of the trans male that we cover in the film is a story of a person who's been very stigmatized, you know, for most of his life. And he finally figured out that he was trans and said, I want to transition. Never thought about fertility, and nor did anyone counsel him. So when he did meet his partner and fell in love, he felt suddenly, you know, I think this could be a beautiful thing to have a child with this man. And these two men had a baby, and I'd like you to watch the show to learn how. but it's a really good story. I think the number one message is there's many ways to build a family, and the technology is allowing that. And yet at the same time, infertility is extraordinarily challenging for people. This film is featuring several different couples facing hurdles that, you know, abound in the world of fertility. So male factor infertility, which is it could be falling sperm count, could be problems with the shape of the sperm, so forth. We're looking at mosaic embryos, which is a controversial embryo, but as science, you know, is catching up to what this embryo represents, it may be an embryo that more and more people can consider transferring and using. So we're capturing cutting-edge technology in this film. We're also looking at the LGBTQ community and the challenges and hurdles they face. And very importantly, we're looking at the structural inequalities in the African-American community. African-Americans suffer infertility at rates twice as high as white women. Why is that? As we've seen with COVID, their health is more compromised. And part of that is a phenomenon called weathering, which is generational oppression, racism, that literally has caused their bodies to prematurely age. And this is impacting, you know, infant mortality rates, fertility rates, all sorts of things. And added to that are myths in the African American community that they're hyperfertile, which is not true. And they don't necessarily seek out help, or maybe not as readily as others. And that's because there's been the history of reproductive coercion in their past. And there's also been a mistrust, because they feel that sometimes in doctor's offices, their concerns are dismissed. And so these things all sort of gather together and contribute to some of these, you know, higher rates of infertility. One area that's very challenging in the world of fertility in the United States is the rural areas, because it's an issue of access. And we've seen that play out in the African American community, but it's true for everybody. I think that if we're, you know, in a society now where we're delaying childbearing time, that you're going to run into more problems because of the aging egg and other issues around sperm, whatever it is. And so you're going to want to have clinics and available to you. And this is a challenge. This film is about the, you know, the infinite possibilities that technology is affording us today for people to have choices. And that, you know, everybody wants to have the opportunity to build a family. And I think that is one of the things that we're reporting on in this film, is updating people on how that's happening.